I said respect must be reciprocal. That's why I use the word mutual respect as an ethic. That is the ethics of this man. No boss is expected if he knows himself, if he is worthy of being called a leader. Because maybe they don't use the word boss, because it is even psychologically, it is a pompous and arrogant concept. It is you that will not have a boss. I'm not supposed to be the one that will say I'm a boss. It brings arrogance. But the simple thing is that if you are a leader, you have helped somebody. It behoves mentorship on you. It behoves privileges of being respected. But it also behoves responsibilities of mentorship on you immediately. So if you know that for every right, there is a responsibility attached to it or a duty attached to it, then you should know that it is psychologically incorrect for you as somebody who should mentor somebody to now be making jest of that person because he has made an error. It is your duty as a leader to continue to train and bring up the people under you. And that is what is regarded as mentorship. Simple. There is no school about it. We are doing it. Come and see how it is done. I have written it. I am expecting you to go and read and see. You have brought it. I have made corrections on it. You go back and look at it and bring up the correction. And so on and so forth. That is where the issue of tolerance also comes in. You have some people that will call you courageous. That you have situations of being courageous people. But it is part of your duty as a leader to tolerate those kind of people. You have people to see people that talk to them, only to discover that the errors that you are seeing are true, are even issues for you. So if you don't have them to look for solutions to some of those issues from home, you may not even get the best from them. Because they have always been coming to work with everybody on their mind. And so their mind is not attuned even to their jobs. So that is why you see some people going out of their ways to assist in persuading, talking to some people, in assisting them to solve some issues, and so on and so forth, that are not even related to this job. People always want people that they can cry on their shoulders. And leaders must make their shoulders available for their subordinates to be able to pour out their minds sometimes. Not even about jobs. That is what is called mentorship. So it is completely wrong for anybody who is ahead or even a step ahead to think it is because you know that you are ahead. So it is therefore your duty to ensure that those coming behind you can also acquire and surpass where you are to be. Like I said, whether you like it or not, obviously you are learning. So if you go and others don't know how to do it, you cannot, if you have conscience, you will not be happy even in that way. When you retire and nobody is able to do the job again, where are you going to collect your pension? If you don't know how to do it in the workplace, it's too much. You cannot say that you are doing the best of it. So, in subordination, under discipline now, somebody mentioned about the subordination and respect for leaders, seniors, as well as people being asked to do things there is what we call obedience to what? Lawful authorities. Obedience to lawful authorities. It is not right for any leader to give instructions that are not right, that are not lawful, because you will not be in a good position to implement discipline when such commands are disrespected. So I therefore implore all leaders to also be very knowledgeable to know what kind of instructions that they will give that will not run foul of the law. Like I give the example of people who will collect interest. Interest is paid into their account, the collector spend it and ask their secretaries to go and hook up receipts. And hook up receipts here and there. Go and go for a receipt for $10,000 and retire so that they can give you the next one. And if and when people resist, they start looking at the person as a bad person, is struggling with me for the money and all of it. It is an unlawful authority, and so if disobey, it is not, cannot claim that it is an insubordination, because you are likely to become even the victim if and when the issues are there. Because if the person is well grounded, he has the right to write straight to report such kind of meeting and be the one now having to respond to queries rather than the queries that you have given to that person. Even when you try to use other offenses to now catch the person is responding. If it's smart enough, go and link it to those kind of issues. And by that, it links it to those kind of issues, they will leave. And the registrar gets the hold of the memo. They will leave the issue that you raise and you start probing into those other issues. There is no limit to when crimes can be investigated. Ensure that you obey and respect your leaders or seniors when they give authorities. Mentorship is simply something that is a culture and it is a must for those who are seniors to do for those who are coming behind them. That is why the authority to assess is given to you as seniors. It is assumed that you are giving mentorship, you have opportunity of looking at those people to see that they are coming up well, and that is why they are asking you to read, so that when you read, the person must believe you. So, and that is why some of us are not doing it right enough. That is why we have lost the culture of even the ratings. People will rate today and give A, only for them to write letters of complaint about the same person. Within the next 3 or 4 months, we'll stipulate or catalog what he or she has been doing for so long. It tells on your own personality too, and I've had causes to tell people that kind of thing. You cannot tell me that this person you are asking me to transfer or send away from your place is the same person that you gave 80% at the last appraisal, because I have record of all the appraisals. So please be honest to yourself and be honest to the system. Procession. Because that, okay, let me. Procession, it is not my creation. I want to say that I've argued it. Mrs. Dowdy is here. There was a particular time that I fought it with me till 12 midnight at one convocation. And my simple response to it is that we are not doing the non-teaching staff any privilege. We are not giving them anything. It is there. Like I said, I have broken it down. Argue it also yourselves. The possession is in columns. And my argument the last time that broke down the truth, even they will never like me for it, is that remove everybody that is neither a shooting or certain members from the procession, and I will ask the non-teaching staff not to come. Because whoever is not a shooting, is not a director, is not a professor, is only coming on that procession as a member of congregation. So it is not me. It is the system that has created it. I only come to defend it. So that is why I have made it clearly done, so that even if I go, you have the answer to this rule. And looking at it quickly, differentiate. There is what they call academic possession. There is convocation possession. What I emphasize here is convocation possession. The other one they call academic possession for inaugural lecture or for matriculation. Don't bother yourself about it. Why? It is just the culture here. In other places, in OU, in OAU, in UNILAG, for inaugural lecture, it's just the principal officers and deans that go to possession. Every other person comes in mufti and sit down and listen to inaugural lecture. Same thing for matriculation. Ask around. There is no such long possession for inaugural lecture. Because if you see, when you come here, you see the needless situation of people what you call the possession. You are not recognized beyond the fact that you sit down. Why? It is a small ceremony, very small ceremony. Matriculation is not supposed to be this is and that. I admit you all, and this is the rule of the university. Register comes and say, please clear the matriculation close. I have to clear the matriculation close. We can do it in 30 minutes and go. What calls for a long possession is that? It's not done. It's revert a culture of waste. Because the time, waste of time, resources, and even personnel. In many universities, it's only matter why there will not even be any something that 200, 300, 400 level students that are doing their lectures. It's only 100 level that is giving that thing. So if everybody is expected to be doing their lectures, why will you bring all registrar to come and stand? No. Inaugural lecture, same. You will see that even in that procession, the only person that is recognized is the dean of the inaugural lecture and the issue. Those are just the two. Every other day you see the nominee. So each time you want to do that, please ignore and don't be part of it. It is not your call. But convocation is a celebration of you. It's a university ceremony. It's an academic ceremony, but a university celebration. That is why the students are involved. So we don't need any new rule to put in place for it to remain. It is there. Once the columns are there, it is accepted. Induction courses, well, we will work towards it and see how it works. Rules and regulations, yes, how regular and whether it can be made available in printed form. But let me say that the world is a dynamic system. The world is a dynamic system. The university system, therefore, is also a system that keeps on changing. The aspect of printing regulations and all that is good. But we are now in a system that is changing so fast. For instance, the last regulation that you know, before it will even be printed, some other things have come up. And that is how it is continuously going to be. What you can do is what we have done. You place the rules and regulations in the hands of the people by putting it on their website, on our website. If you go to the website today, you will see it there. What we just needed to do is to be computer literate enough to see whether even printed books are disappearing, not to talk of printed regulations. It is the same thing that the issue of how regular it is to be answered. There is no time frame for review of career structure, or what can only be happening is accommodating the changes as they come. It is not every time that you sit down and start talking about how to bring about career structure. For instance, in the last 2-3 years, we have accommodated certain things even in the health center because of changes in their career structure along the way. We had disagreement, for instance, between chief nursing officers and these graduate nurses and all the rest, because circulars continue to come out and just be wiping away what you call rules and regulations. So these things have been reviewed unknowingly. They are being reviewed. Issue of, if you look at career structure, the printed one on you, you're still talking about countries, what is an appointment. But now what are we doing? It is now promotion. Even though we can do appointment, but we have made it promotional. And we have introduced certain conditions to get that promotion. This is a review of the regulation as it is going. So we cannot say that it must be done every 5 years. If we do so, we are limiting and asking those things to wait till another 5 years. So what we can only be asking and praying for is to continue to have a management that will be dynamic enough to incorporate these changes as they come. And we continue to review them and making them available. See the one we mentioned about daily releases. We have issues with it. We have reviewed it and say, okay, when we finish, rest for 2 years to allow others to also enjoy. If we have to wait for another 5 years, it won't happen that way. So it will continue that way.